in my middle school English class, all the cool kids sat in the same row, and they always sat in the same order because we had assigned seating. Now, how do we know they were cool? Well, we could tell by the color of their shirts because, well, apparently that's how you tell who's cool in middle school. And yes, yeah, those are shirts, red, blue, black, and white. And I realize it's a good thing that I'm a lot better at math than I am at drawing because, well, unless you've been dead for at least 50 or 100 years, being good at math pays better than being good at drawing. And besides, good math lasts forever. I mean, name three Greek artists. No ancient Greek artists? How about three ancient Greek mathematicians? Euclid, Pythagoras, Archimedes, and I could go on and on and on. Because art is, you know, largely a reflection of its time. It's a product of its time, but math is timeless. And now back to our story. Unfortunately, the cool kids couldn't just pick any color they wanted to. You know, you have to work hard to stay cool. Because the way you stay cool is to make sure that no two people in a row, no two people next to each other have the same color shirt on. So I had to work very hard to do this. You know, they'd call each other the night before and plan their outfits to make sure they stay cool by making sure that no two people that are next to each other are wearing the same color shirt. You know, that would be very bad. Now the question, of course, is, in how many ways could they pick their shirts? How many ways can they go choose their shirts and sit in their row and stay cool? Because that's so incredibly important. Well, we could start listing them out, but that would take forever, and we'd have no idea if we had them all once we had our list. So the way we're going to count this is think about how, if the cool kids were also smart kids, how they might go about constructing one order that's okay. So, how will we do this? Well, imagine we just started from the beginning, and we let Anne choose first, and she can choose any color she wants to. Anything she wants to. Any of these four, because that's all she has, because, you know, you have to be white, black, blue, or red to stay cool. But that gives her four choices. So she chooses and tells Bob. Right? And for example, say she chooses blue, and I'm not going to try to draw a shirt because, well, you see my drawing skills. Well, next up comes Bob. She tells Bob what color she chose. And Bob now has three choices. He can't choose blue, and we're not worried about Cam yet. So he gets to choose next, and Cam has to wait for Bob to choose. So say Bob chooses black, and he had three choices. So for each of Anne's four choices, Bob will have three choices, no matter what. Now we look at Cam. Well, Cam, she has to look at Bob and say, well, Bob's wearing black. I can't wear black. So Cam has three choices, because Bob is her only restriction. We're not worried about Deb yet. Say she chooses white, then along comes Deb. Just as Cam only had three choices and Bob only had three choices, Deb has three choices, anything but white. So say she chooses black. Same game with Eli. Eli only has three choices. Chooses white, and then Fran. The only thing Fran can't do is white. So she has three choices as well. Let's say she picks blue. And as you can see, now we can count how many ways they can choose their shirts. For each of Anne's four choices, Bob has three. So there are four times three ways Anne and Bob can choose. For each of these four times three ways that Anne chooses a shirt and Bob chooses a shirt, Cam has three choices as well. So it's 4 times 3 times 3, and we just continue. And now we just compute this. We have 4 times 3 to the 5th, and that equals, let's see, 3 to the 5th, 243. And 4 times 243, 4 times 240, that's 960. 4 times 3 is 12. 960 plus 12, 972. They have 972 ways that they can choose their shirts. And the strategy we took here is what I like to call constructive counting. What we did is we thought about how would the cool people choose their shirts if they wanted to stay cool. We're just trying to construct one sequence of choices. If we think about how the cool people would actually do it, how they would make their choices, sometimes that tells us how we can count them. And it's exactly what we did here. We thought, hey, Anne can choose first, and she has four choices. And then once she's chosen, then Bob has three choices. Then Cam has three choices, and Deb and Eli, and so on. However, well, turns out Cam likes to be difficult. So Cam went through a goth phase, and she insisted she would always wear black. You know, that's all she would wear. She would never wear white. She would never wear blue. Never wear red. She only would wear black, and everyone else would just have to deal with it. So Cam's just wearing black. Now Eli said, well, you know, there's enough darkness in the world. We don't need Cam clouding everything up. So Eli was going to offset Cam and tease her and probably flirt with her by always wearing white. So we've got Cam always wearing black and Eli always wearing white. But they have to stay cool, right? I mean, it's very important. Have to stay cool. No two people next to each other can wear the same color shirt. So how many ways can they do it now? Well, clearly Cam and Eli, they only have one choice. They've made their choice. They're going to have to live with that. But now if we start from the beginning here with Anne, well, it looks like she has four choices. But then how many choices does Bob have? If Anne chooses black, then Bob has three choices. He can choose white, blue, or red. But if Anne chooses something other than black, say she chooses red, well, then Bob only has two choices. So if we just start with Anne, then we run into a problem. So instead of starting with Anne, what we're going to do is we're going to start from the most restricted of the cool people. Think about, well, if the cool people are actually going to be picking their shirts, well, Deb here in the middle is the most restricted. She can't pick black. She can't pick white. So she can only pick red or blue. So she only has two choices. Now, let's say she chooses, I'll let her choose red. And then working our way out, you see that Fran's restricted, only can't choose white. It's the only thing she can't choose, so she has three choices. Say she chooses black. And then we have Bob. Bob is only restricted by Cam now. Bob has three choices. And let's say Bob chooses white. And now Anne can choose anything except for whatever Bob chose. Anne has three choices. And we'll let her choose black since then I want to pick up another pen. So now, once again, we can count. And all we've done is another case of what I called constructive counting. I thought about how they would pick their shirts. And we have 2 times 3 cubed possibilities. 3 cubed is 27. 2 times 27 is 54. So we see that just because Cam and Eli insist on being difficult, we now have way fewer choices. But of course, if they had just decided that it doesn't really matter who's cool, then everybody would have a lot more choices, and that would be pretty nice. But now we're going to move on to some more problems and some more lessons, because we're finished talking about cool people, so we can move on to something a lot more interesting.